Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is The Cask of Amontillado by Edgar Allan Poe in Middle English. This video was requested by Saucer on my Discord. It was meant to be a Halloween special, but due to scheduling difficulties is now coming out as an All Sales Day special instead. The text you will see on screen is the original English. You can find the Middle English version by following the link in the description. I wish you all a pleasantly macabre day, and without further ado. The thousand injuries of Fortunato ich habe borne es ich cure best, but whence he ventureth upon Edwit, ich vouted vengeance. Thou, who so well knoweth the quiddite of min soul, willst not supposen, however, that that yieldeth a threat. Ich would ben avenged, alarsch, that was a point settled restingly, but the very definitivité with which it was resolved precluded the idea of plea. Ich bure not miri aderen, but aderen non sententiously. A tort bith not addressed when vengeance overtaketh the redressing. It bith not redressed as well, when the venger faileth to maken himselven felten as such to him who hath committeth the tort. It thare been openly that neither with word nor deed hath ich given reason to Fortunato to o'erthrown min god wille. Ich continuatet, as was min wont, to smilen at his face, and he did not ascheaten min smile, to ban at the cognitation of his insension. He hath a non-power, that Fortunato, although in different regards he was a man of resport and to ban bedowed. He flencheth himselven in his cogningness on vin. Feve Italians haven the plain virtuoso spirit. Foremost, their vigor is chosen to fit the occasion to fatten the Britonish and Austrian richesse. In Paintorie and Gemarie, Fortunato, like his Ileades, was an idiote, but in the cunningness of Vin he was true. In that field ich was not plainly different from him. Ich was seeing in the Italian vintages min one, muchly what ich couth. It was about twilichting one evening, during the supreme mudding of the carnival teams, that ich countered min friend. He dressed me with overmete heartliness, for he had overdrinkinge. The man was clad in motle. He was vestured in a tight dress, and up on his head was the conical bonnets and skelets. Ich was so glad to beholden him, that ich thought ich should never to cease tricking his hand. Ich said unto him, Min dear Fortunato, thou art luckily countered. How remarkably, God, thou art to behold that day. But ich habe in heaven a costrol of what is purported as Amontillado, und ich habe mine dubitations. Hohe, said he, Amontillado a costrol of? Impossible! And in the midst of carnival? Ich habe mine dubitations, ich replied. And ich was so foolish to pay in the plain Amontillado price without thine conseil. Thee were not to ben finde, and ich was afeard of verlosen a morchondi.
Amontillado!
Ich habe meinen dubitations.
Amontillado!
And ich mot they saulen.
Amontillado!
As thou art Ziesel, ich ware gone to Lucrezi. If anyone haveth the cunningness, hit is he. He will sayen min
Lucrezia knoweth to tell an Amontillado from sherry.
Still, some fools claim his taste to be one of the puissance of your own.
Come, let us go.
Whither? To thine cellar. Min friend, no, ich will not misnote thing God welle. Ich see thee to ban over busy. Lucrezi, ich am not over busy. Come. Min friend, no, it beeth not thy overbusiness, but the puissant cold with which I ascheaten thou to ben ithrowen. The cellar beeth intolerably damp. They are slimed with salt nitre.
Let us go, not the less. The cold beast not. Amontillado! Du hadest been misnoted. And concerning Lucrezi, he knoweth to tell an Amontillado from Sherry.
Thus speaking, Fortunato framed himself of mine arm, and, donning a mask of black silk, and drawing a roquelaire closely about me, ich was hurried to mein palazzo. There be no servants at mein home, they have outfared to make a merriment in honor of the team. Ich habe told them that ich should not returnen until the morn, und ich habe given sterne commandes to them not to stray from the house. These commanders were sufficient, ich well knowe, to assure their wit-like outfaring, once mein back was turned. Ich talke from the sconces to the henne, and, giving one to Fortunato, conveyed him through several suites of rooms to the tresons that led into the cellar. Ich transiten adown steire, asking his ivariness as he involved. We are landed at last at this end of the descense, and inbland stavenet at the damp grunde of the understone of the Montresors. The trot of mein friend was steady alas, and the sonnette upon his cap jingled as he straget.
The costrol, he said. Hit beeth yonder ward, said ich, but observe the wit webs which shimen from these cisterne walls. He turned till me, and peered into mein eyes with two filmed balls that stilled the reum of vinolence.
Sold nitre? He asked.
Sold nitre, ich replied.
How long have thou had that cough? Mein lamentable friend found it impossible to reply for many a minute.
Hint bist not,
he said at last. Komme, ich said, with determination. We will turn back, thin sante bis yearningly. Thu arish, respondertet, commandable, predelict, thu are silly, as once ich have been. Thu are no man to ben forlosen. For myself it bis no importance. We will turn back, thu will be unsent, and ich cannot be guilty. Besides, there bith Lucrezi.
Enough, he said. The cough bith a mere not. It will not sly on me. Ich shall not perish from a cough.
True, true, ich replied. And indeed, ich had no intention of alarming thee without cause. But the thare use all proper caution. A tigger of that medoc will be varying us from the dumps. Here ich uncorked the neck of a costrol which I withdrew from a long rank of its fellows that lay upon the dump. Drink, ich said, proffering the vin. He raised it to his lips with a star. He made pause and nodded to me friendly, while his sonnetes jingled.
Ich drink, he said, to the period that ereste around us.
And ich to thine long life. He retook mein arm, and we went on.
That cellar, said he, bith great.
The Montresors, ich replied, were large and numberful family.
I forget thine armour.
A huge human foot door, in a field azure, the foot knash a serpent rampant, whose fangs been immersed in the hele.
And the words?
Nemo me impune lassesit.
Good, he said.
The wind sprinkled in his eyes, and the sonnettes jingled. Mein own fancy growe warm from the medoc. We transited through long walls of pillet skeletons, with casks and trussels inmixting into the innest depths of the understone. Ich mad pause once more, and third him ich emboldened to grab Fortunato by arm beyond the elbow.
The salt nitre, ich said, see, it expounds. It hangs like mousse upon the cellar.
We are neither the ripari vere.
The drops of damp trickle amongst the bones. Come, we will turn back, ere it be too late. Thank cough, it be not, he said. Let us go on. But first, another tiger of the Medoc. Ich yielded and handed to him the flacket of the Grave. He voided it wit-like. His eyes lated with the strolly liquid. He lauched and upithringed the bottle with a gesticulation ich ill understande. Ich peered at him astounded. He replicated the gesture, an unwit one.
Du misunderstand?
He said. Not ich, ich replied.
Then they are not of the confrarie.
Ho?
They are not of the maisons.
Yes, yes, ich said. Yes, yes.
Du? Impossible. A maison?
A maison, ich replied.
A sign, he said. A sign.
It be that, ich antwortet, fordering from neath the folds of my vestment a trowel.
The jest,
he exclaimed, repulsed a few strides.
But let us go on to the Amontillado.
Ben it so, ich said, replacing the towel beneath the cope and again proffering mein arm. He leaned upon it heavily. We continued our itinerarie, scouting the Amontillado. We transited ranks of lower agaves, netherted, transited, and netherted again. I landed at a deep groove, in which the weff in the air caused our techene to clomen instead of sheenen. At the innest end of the groove, there atavie an other, less spacious. His walls had been leaned with scuddes, hooped to the great cellars overhead, in the fashion of the great understone of Paris. Traces of their innermore cruft were still animated thuswise. From the first side, the bones had been cast down and lay wantonly upon the earth, forming agendring at one point a hoge of some mochenesse. Within the wall thus exposed by the displacement of the bones, we saw yet another innermore cruft or alignment, in depth about 4 foot, in breadth 3, in height 6 or 7. It appeared upit for no especial use for itself, but formed merely the interval betwixt 2 of the Geon's restorers of the first of the Understone, and was backed by one of their imloquening walls of massive flintstone. It was for naught that Fortunato, apacking his lithes rufe, kunnef to sporen into the depth of the alignment. Its ends the lithy licht did not empower us to see. Paforthe, ich said, herinne is dem Amontillado. As for Luchresi, he is an unwitte, interrupted mein friend, as he toe-stepped, while er in full wit wit-like at his hele. In an eien berthenes he bith arrived at the end of the niche, and finding his progress halted by the stone, steventet volley be maset. A moment on, and ich have bolted him to the flintstone. In its superficite were 2 iron warlocks, one distanced from the other 2 feet. From one of these hung a short chain, from the other a hanglock. Torving the links around his girdle stede, it was quick work to fasten it. He was too wandered to adsitten. With clapping the care, ich frostepped the alignment. Pass thy hand, ich said, o'er the wall. You cannot help feeling the salt nitre. Indeed, it be very damp. Once again, let me beseech thee to returnen. No? Then ich thare belaten thee. But ich first thare renden thee all the little ministrations of min potentie.
The Amontillado,
yell mein friend, not yet wurped from the bemasement. True, ich replied, the Amontillado. As ich spake these words, ich werket among the piles of bones, of which I have spoken earlier. Torving them aside, ich sonne und quelmet, a mountainess of piers and mortar. With these materials and with the art of mein troll,
Ich said about strictly to be valent the ingress of the niche. Ich had scarcely laid the first tier of wall, when ich spähe that the vinulence of Fortunato had in great man subsided. The earliest evidence I had of this was the vist moaning cry from the depth of the alignment. It was not the cry of a vinulent man. There was then a longe and wilsome stilthe. Ich leite the second röhe, and the thirde, and the fourthe, and then ich oft heard the furiel trinklingle of the chain. The lude dured several minutes, during which I assesche on the pile of harken for min pleasing. When at last the tickling alithed, ich retook the trowel and accomplished without cessation the fifthe, sixthe, and seventhe röhe. The wall was hignaue to min klibane. Ich again mit pause, and abhabbing the techene of the masonry, sheened a few pale steam up on the fasure within. A process of shill and kete shouted, weeping geringe from the gargle of the chained fasure, besemet to abthringen me iruesli bechte. For an art instant, ich studeget, ich biviet. Outshedding min sword, ich bekamen to graspen about the alignment, but the thought of an instant hurted me. Ich blaset min hand upon the solidity of the understone, and felt pleased. Ich inechlechet again the wall. Ich replied to the yells of the clamorer. Ich within a sonnet. Ich filsted. Ich o'ermunted him with magnitude and strengthed. Ich did this, and the clamorer grew stille. It was no midnight, and mein Werk was nearing end. Ich had accomplished the eighte, ninte, and tithe Rauhe. Ich had finished a partage of the last and eleventh Rauhe. Merely a singular stone remained to be fitted and emplastered. Ich hanne with its heft, ich idonit in part in its position. But noe, there are landed from the niche a low lauch that pricked the hair upon mein head. It was volven by a surly voice, which ich had trouble yetting as that of Othel Fortunato. The voice said,
a very fine chest in that, a grandiose chest. We should have many a great lauch about it at the palazzo. Or our win.
The Amontillado, ich said.
Yes, the Amontillado. But be it not getting late, will not they be awaiting us at the palazzo, the Lady Fortunato and the rest? Let us be gone.
Yes, ich said. Let us be gone.
For the love of God, Montresor!
Yes, ich said, for the love of God. But to these words I hearkened in vain for a reply. Ich became impatient. Ich yelled aloud, Fortunato! No reply. Ich yelled again.
Fortunato!
No reply. Still. Ich jobbed a rufe through the remaining word and let it rise within. Rese came forth in a reply only a gangling of the sonnets. Mein courage evilet, it was the damp of the understone that made it so. Ich hastened for make mind of mein Werk. Ich rammed the last stone into position. Ich emplastered it. Against the new masonry ich re-erected the old pile of bones. For a half century, no hassle haveth entroubled them. In pace requiescat.
This has been The Cask of Amontillado, read in Middle English. Please note that my own Middle English is not perfect. I am not studying Middle English, but just common linguistics. If you have any suggestions as to errors I might have made, please submit them in the comments below. I hope you have enjoyed your time and had a proper macabre time listening to this, as Edgar Allan Poe himself would have intended. I certainly shuddered once I realized that the protagonist of this story was just going to kill Fortunato, almost having forgotten the intro over how he spoke of Fortunato as his friend. Please give me any additional feedback you might have about the quality of this video in terms of a like, a dislike, a comment, or any other form you see fit. If you want to stay in touch with me, there are links to my Twitter and my Discord server in the description below. I hope you have a pleasant rest of day, and I'll see you around.